Dankeschön. Im Namen der
Thank you. On behalf of the Greens EFA group, I call Mrs. Harms for 2.5 minutes. Thank you very much, Madam President. I must confess I was a little confused when I thought about the debate today. Not so much because I think that we should only have a debate when we have a new Russia strategy, once that has been agreed to. Unfortunately, Mr. Fleckenstein has left, and you know, he talked about the 120 colleagues who aren't here. Well, similarly, he has left the chamber. Anyway, it's not so much that. I think that if we look at what we've done to date, it's not really taken us that far, has it? And I think that there are two camps in the European Union. Some will say this was too much, the tone was all wrong, we need to tone it down a bit in terms of our relations with Russia. The other camp said, well, we've not been consistent enough, in fact, and we need to do more, go further. In the meantime, I mean, I would argue that it can't continue like this. And this lack of decisiveness here in the European Union is, in fact, one of our biggest problems. It's actually a guarantee for failure, as I see it. The European Union has never really declared Russia or the Kremlin the enemy. I've been observing the situation for some time now. Particularly since the annexation of Crimea and the war in Donbass. You know, there have been other events, of course, bombing of Syria, Aleppo, by way of an example, or indeed the toxic gas attack in the UK. I think that as time goes by, things are becoming more clear. This is a signal coming from Russia vis-a-vis the West. They want to demonstrate that Russia is strong and that Russia is acting against what we've done in the West. How do you now handle this? Is there a new opportunity, particularly after these reactions? There's been the response, the airstrikes on chemical sites in Syria. Is this now a new window of opportunity to talk about this? I don't know, but I find it very, very interesting. President Macron, in the debate today, and I noticed this with interest, you know, he says that I think we need to look at very carefully what kind of opportunities there are for change in the Kremlin, and that's all well and good. But when things get as difficult as they have done in the Donbass, even with a ceasefire in Syria, and recently Russia has done everything it possibly can to support greater escalation. They supported the Turks in Afrin when it came to Iran, their new position of power vis-a-vis Syria as well, all of this. If we fail there, then what does that mean in terms of the set of instruments that we have and sanctions that we need to work on? I think that it's come to a point where the EU needs to use its economic might, its economic clout to do something more. The speaker is interrupted. The President, I'm afraid you have spoken already for 3 minutes, Mrs. Harms, rather than the 2.5 minutes allocated to